people look at him and think he's angry or because he has no facial expression whatsoever. Sometimes he gets frustrated when people can't understand him.
Dawson has Mobius Syndrome. It means that he's had no facial movement on both sides of his face ever since birth, and he also has the inability to move his eyes laterally out to the sides.
People take it for granted. You know, you can smile when you're happy and frown when you're sad, and you know, he never had that. He is funny. He loves to make people laugh. He loves to laugh. So just very loving, you know, outgoing. Just wants to be part of the crowd.
Dr. Alison Snyder-Warwick, pediatric plastic surgeon, will perform two surgical procedures that she hopes will restore movement to Dawson's face, give the six-year-old the ability to smile for the first time in his life.
In order to get facial movement, you need two things. You need muscle, and you also need a nerve to move that muscle. And so in Dawson's case, because this all developed when he was developing in utero, in the womb, we need to replace both of those things because he doesn't have normal nerve or muscle there.
Dr. Snyder-Warwick performed the first procedure on Dawson's left side.
He did really well. They took the gracilis muscle out of his left leg and put it in the left side of his face.
Then we find a different nerve in the face that Dawson does have, and that's called the masseteric nerve, which is normally used in chewing. So that nerve gets connected to this muscle that we transfer to the face, and we orient it from the corner of the mouth up near the temple.
And then they wait.
We were expecting sensation around 4 to 6 months after the surgery. About a month and a half afterwards, he was able to already move it. So it was very, very shocking to us and very, very exciting. I was actually at work when it happened, so Dad had called me to tell me. And, you know, of course I'm at work and I'm crying. You know, it's just exciting. I got home and I was just, you gotta show me. So then I called the doctor and I'm like, you know, he's doing it. Of course, I didn't expect her to believe me.
And I said, oh, okay, you know, kind of thinking, I don't really think that's true movement. You know, maybe there was some muscle spasm or something that happened. But she sent me a picture via email because they do live quite a distance away. And it looked very real.
She said that was the soonest she's ever seen anybody have results.
And then when they came to the clinic, of course, I was able to verify that indeed he's got great movement of his cheek. And the picture that she had sent was, you know, just the very beginning of that. But she had told me that it had been very consistent from the time that she had called. So that really surprised me that he had had movement so quickly.
3 months later, Dawson returned to St. Louis Children's Hospital to repair the right side of his face.
I was hopeful that he would do just as well, but I didn't know if it was just an anomaly last time and now he'd be kind of more of the standard course or, you know, maybe even a little slower.
Probably about a month and a half, 2 months when he started having movement, just in time for picture day for school this year. So that was very exciting.
I was a little bit nervous because they hadn't called and it was time for his next visit. And I was worried that maybe this side wasn't working. And then Dawson walked in from the waiting room and he didn't give me any smiles on the walk-in. He walked right past me. And then he sat down and his mom said, "We'll show her." And he gave me this big smile on both sides of the face. So that was really rewarding and actually a little bit of a relief too.
He's been healing from his second surgery, learning to control his muscles that have been placed in his face. And he's gotten really great control over him now, a lot sooner than we expected, just like the first time around. It's a little difficult for him to, we're learning when he needs to do it and when he shouldn't do it and be aware that there's emotion that's connected to it.
over time, people become more adjusted to the new kind of scenario, and having the social interactions that they have throughout their life, they learn how to smile without thinking about it.
And so it's just a learning experience for them.
Smiles are such beautiful things. They tell you so much about a person. There is no better feeling than seeing a child get their smile back or smile for the first time.
We are very appreciative for everything she has done and very grateful that she was brought here to our area to where we could, you know, proceed with this with her.
The program at St. Louis Children's Hospital and Washington University School of Medicine is one of only a small handful in the U.S. that focuses on facial reanimation, Dr. Snyder-Warwick's specialty.
Working with children is so rewarding because they really have a great perspective on life.
And knowing Dawson will have an easier time fitting in with his peers gives his mom something to smile about.
I just absolutely love his smile. It brings a smile to my face every time I see him use it.
There we go.
Make sure you smile, Dawson.